Hello again, this is the Master Plan. You're watching part 2 of 4 of the 5th playthrough video for Evil Twin Cyprien's Chronicles. I'm going to drunk walk a bit, and then I'm going to talk to the spider.
So, have you got my flykitos?
Yes, but I found only one.
Give it to me. Delicious. Here, take my web.
Did you make a net out of it?
Yes. Why? Does it bother you?
No, it's just bizarre, that's all.
Well, I mean to say, it keeps me busy. Some people do knitting. I make nets.
Of course. How stupid of me.
So I just got the net that I was referring to in the other video so that I can do another one of the sections, which is going to get cut from this section, but I'll let you know when it comes up. Picking up where I left off in the last video, there are several different sections that get unlocked as you complete more objectives and things, and the video is going to keep being choppy, so just roll with it, because there's, I don't know what's wrong, I've just been tired lately, I guess, and I just keep messing up simple things a lot. This is the little cutscene for the area that I'm skipping. As you can see, it has all these leaves and hints of gusts of wind and things, and you're basically supposed to float through the whole thing, but you sure don't. And basically, you only have to collect 16 of the little firefly things, like you see there, little yellow deals. But I'll tell you, it's positively frustrating. So I'm gonna go ahead and skip that. And now that I have the net, I caught the fireflies. It somehow turns itself into a lantern, which I will use in the video after this one to go to the little termite realm, which is in that hole that, on the right there, that I just passed. That's on my left. To be able to see in front of me. And that one's actually nifty, because most of this game is in 3D, but there's some very old school 2D kind of platforming thing going on where it's side-scrolling, which is actually nice for a change, because there's less room for error, really. But now I'm going to go up through the leaves here and tackle another section. That beetle is going to help along the story of how Vince's Island got to where it is and why the praying mantises and I guess the ladybugs that fly around are trying to kill you all the time, which is a good tidbit of information because they're actually really annoying. It just seems like it takes 1,000 shots for them to die, but luckily for this part I only have to kill 3, I think. So this video is going to jump around a lot too, just because of like missed jumps and things, so it's going to be Chop City. But this section's really not even that interesting, so it's not like you're really missing anything. You just have to pick up a Super Cyprien power up. I was waiting for it to respawn. I'm going to set my jump up because I missed it 5 times before this. Thank you, camera angles. And make my way around and talk to the beetle, and then he's gonna ask me to kill the praying mantises.
Help
and then I'm gonna do it.
Help! Wow.
So talk, enjoy the cutscene.
Well, my boy, you were sent by Providence. I'm definitely in need of help.
Yeah, well, so I see. But I don't really see how I'm supposed to get you out of that cage.
The problem isn't so much the cage as the praying mantises. Here they come! Help me!
Shit, he seems pretty scared, which is weird because I don't see anything. Oh, wait, there they are. So there's the annoying ladybug things that shoot like 2D balls at you for some reason. It's kind of funny, they're just annoying because the game uses an auto-targeting system, so as long as there's something near you that is an enemy and you shoot, 9 out of 10 times I'll start shooting it, but the same does not apply for the first person view, as I found out the hard way. It worked there just because I got lucky, but when I try to do it again, it doesn't really work. It's a good thing, like I said, that I'm using cheats, because I have rapid fire on, and I also have extra strength shots. So if you think it takes forever to kill one with cheats on, I can't even imagine playing it normally. But, you know, I can only upload so many videos, and I want to get this whole game on YouTube if it's possible. I believe that there are 8 sections in all, and this is, I guess technically this is the first of 8, but because there's one island for 5 different friends, I believe, and then there is Flyville, which is the hardest thing in the entire game, and then there's Lorandarth, which is the place that they were talking about in the beginning, where you have your confrontation with the Master, and there's some really interesting stuff coming up. It's just these first couple environments aren't particularly inspired, I don't think. Like I said in the last video, I mean, I'm really not super crazy about this island at all. You know, whether it's the level design or the art's just really not that great on this one.
You just saved me from certain death. Now it's my turn to help you. What can I do for you?
Well, for starters, you could explain why the Manuses hate us so much.
Oh, upon my word. I must admit that I don't really know. We used to live peacefully on this island. This was the realm of plants and insects, and Vince made sure we had a regular and life-enhancing environment. Then, one day, there was a great tidal wave, and Vince began to think about nothing except himself and his own well-being. He abandoned us for a bulb that gives him enchanting visions, and he doesn't have to do a thing. That's when the Black Root appeared and began to invade the whole island with its evil creatures. Of course, Vince has no idea what's happening here. He's too busy enjoying himself. And look at me! Oh, stuck in this accursed cage!
Okay. Well, then we're just going to have a few words with this Black Root. Do you know where it hangs out?
It's everywhere! Every root, every evil creature, every blade of every weed belongs to it. Soon it will have covered the whole island, and we'll be powerless.
I didn't ask you to make a prophecy. I just asked where it lives. Its place of residence, see?
Follow the tree. In the center of its hollow core, you will find the root.
Follow the tree. Okay, then let's follow the tree. And don't worry, everything's gonna be okay.
Now that doesn't make sense, because that's how I got here. So I actually have to look into that, because I remember that not being the case. But it doesn't really matter, because after this I have to go into the hole that I was telling you about before and go meet with the termites and stuff. And then I have to go kill the Black Root, which, again, monstrous boss battle thing is absolutely gigantic. And especially considering how hard it is to control things in first person mode, knowing that you have to precisely shoot a couple parts of his body and that he's attacking you the whole time, it's more difficult than it needs to be. And I mean, you're just seeing now some of the bugs I was talking about before, and how many problems this game really has as a game. But like I was saying, I mean, you know, these next couple videos, they're really just for the story. You're not really going to see anything terribly interesting until I get into the middle of the game. So, but there's lots of interesting stuff to be had, so keep watching if for nothing else to advance the story until some of the more interesting artwork and design comes into play.
What?
I'll see you next time.
All right, just a second. A little smile, and bingo.
Thanks, see ya.